Be in Lima. Today is definitely the day.
So I'm currently in Plaza San Martin.
Plenty of things to do.
It's a pretty centric area, the palace. There's nobody else but me, and that's because there's a protest going on, but I was able to kind of talk my way into coming in here. Look at this beauty. You can see, this is a tight fit.
A few moments later.
Mi nombre es Luis. Soy el bartender de acá del Museo del Pisco y ahora vamos a elaborar un pisco sour, que es un pisco tradicional. Un cóctel temático acá al Perú, que es mayormente con un pisco destilado de la uva. Ya los primeros ingredientes son el pisco, el segundo ingrediente es el limón, el tercer ingrediente es el jarabe de goma y por último la clara de huevo. Es un batido refrescado, no licuado, mayormente algunos lo licúan y no te quedaría muy bien porque licuarlo se aguachenta y no quedaría en su punto. Es un refrescado nada más con nuevos 4 o 5 cubitos de hielo y nada más batido. Como ahora vamos a presentar de acá es una coctelera, vaso Gibraltar. Este es un oncero medidor para medir las onzas de los ingredientes, ¿ya? El grande es 2 onzas, el mediano chiquito es 1. Vamos a echarle 1 de 2 y 1 de media onza. Pasamos al preparado, que es el pisco primero, como te dije. 2 onzas, damos la vuelta. Echamos uno y un poquito de más. Pasamos al limón. Al jarabe de goma. Echamos primero el hielo. Y por último echamos la clara del huevo, ¿eh? Cerramos y damos un batido consistente, nada más. Para arriba, para abajo, para arriba, para abajo, para arriba, para abajo, para arriba, para abajo, hasta esperar a que se forme el pisco. Vas a darte cuenta que se va a volver un poco blanco, espumoso, y se va a dar la reducción de la espuma. Seguimos. Queda, abrimos, este es un vaso quiero, mayormente es de 10 a 11 onzas que tiene, damos un doble colado, por último echamos un amargo de Angostura. Es un bitter clásico hecho de hierbas aromáticas para no captar el aroma, el olor a clara de huevo. ¿Cuál es su nombre?
Eric.
Eric. Wow. Bueno, Eric, este es el famoso pisco sour tradicional que preparamos acá en el Perú.
Muchas gracias.
Y así como queda el pisco sour. Pásalo a probar. Espero te guste.
Well, there you have it, guys. That's how a pisco sour is made, and now I'm going to try it and see how it tastes. Muy rico. Gracias. It's really good, guys.
My Peru adventure was off to an amazing start. However, one pisco sour was not enough. So I was on to the next bar to see the difference, since every bar has their own style of making this drink.
Y salimos. Siempre la preferencia es que tenga un dedo de medio de espuma. Y decoramos con unas gotas de bitter, una angostura, que es una maceración de hierbas, cortezas aromáticas.
So yeah, as you guys can see, like, since its creation, it's had a whole bunch of different types of different styles that each bar has created. So now I'm going to go ahead and try their style, which this is the Pisco Sour Catedral, correct? Yes. So let's go ahead and give it a try and see how it tastes. It's really good. It's a pretty strong drink, stronger than all the other ones that I've had, but just as good, and it tastes very delicious. Thank you. You can find a whole bunch of bars in this area, and they each have their own different style, whether it's like the classic pisco sour or their own version of it. Very delicious. All right, guys, what I'm about to eat right now is known as lomo saltado, which is pretty much beef with potatoes, but this is, instead of potatoes, this is replaced with yuca, which is still pretty good with a side of rice. So I'm gonna try it right now and see how it tastes. I'm pretty sure it tastes great. It already looks amazing, so bon appetit, guys. It's really good. And then this, I'm sure you could just taste it. It's really good. I definitely recommend this place.
My first day in Peru was in the books. I was excited to continue exploring this beautiful country, known for its delicious food and friendly culture. I felt that this was the beginning of an unforgettable trip, and my intuition was right. In Peru, there were many more surprises ahead.